ASHLYN Carter. Welcome back to my channel. I have been in a hosting frenzy these days. We're back with another Set the Table series. This edition would be called Hosting Six Girls on a Weeknight when I get home an hour before they're due to arrive and I'm single parenting. If you're new here, you know that Set the Table series is my encouragement to you to open your doors, open your home. It doesn't have to be complicated. It doesn't have to be fussy. My heart is for others, and the way I feel like I get the most fulfillment is opening the doors to our home. Messiness, craziness, my husband's out of town for 6 days and all, and just love on people. And if you've been around here for a while, you know that I host a college girls group at my house. Well, a new group is on their way in, but my beloved seniors that graduated, I miss them dearly already. I'm having them over tonight, the ones that just graduated, because I miss them, I love them, and I just wanna bless them with a good meal. But it is a little bit crazy around here, so these are some few things that I did to make tonight go easy. I'm prepping everything in advance. So I made salted brown butter chocolate chip cookie dough yesterday, and I currently have them baking right now. And then for dinner, because it is all women, I wanted to do something fun and light. I'm doing a really fun cheese board, everything I purchased at Trader Joe's. Very simple, very easy. So that will be the starter, but also part of dinner. And then I'm gonna do just a really big, delicious kale salad. I bought the pre-bagged, chopped organic kale, pre-washed. I'm gonna do that, a fall salad with caramelized onions, pomegranate seeds, nuts. I'm gonna have bacon and goat cheese on the side that people that like those things can add to it. What's awesome about the salad is I can just make everything in advance, and then I will make the balsamic maple dressing that I will drizzle on top right before. When I get home from soccer practice, I will get out all the cheese board stuff. And then one of my favorite, even though it is such a hot day here, one of like the best dishes by Sprouted Kitchen is her roasted tomato soup. So I've already roasted all my tomatoes, onions, and garlic this morning. Really easy. And then I have those ready to go into my Dutch oven that I will put on the stove after practice. And it's really easy. You just add it to broth, salt and pepper it, you boil it for a little bit, and then I'll use my immersion blender and have it as a side dish. So we've got our easy kale salad, we've got our delicious tomato bisque, and then we have a huge cheese board with some meats and cheeses and just lots of yummy things. And then for dessert, like I said, I'm keeping it simple with this brown butter chocolate chip cookie recipe. I made the dough yesterday, baked them today, so they're fresh, they'll be warm, with a little scoop of ice cream. Super easy, and this meal will be very filling and satisfying, and it's perfect for all women because we don't really have a lot of, we don't really need like a lot of heavy meats or protein. So it's fun, it's light, it's delicious. If you're wondering what this is the bacon that I'm gonna bake and crumble for the kale salad. If you watched last week's Birthday Girl Set the Table series, some of the flowers, including like the little white and green ones and the Dusty Miller, were still in awesome shape. Everything else from a week ago was feeling a little bit sad. So a little tip for you, you can recycle a lot of your flowers. So I pulled out some of the yucky roses and such. I went to Trader Joe's this morning. I bought two bunches of dahlias. Dahlias are in season right now. They're late summer to fall. Some beautiful, just colorful, fun dahlias. Two bunches, they're both $5 each. And I added those, I pulled out all the yucky flowers, I added those to the new ones, to the existing ones, and there you go. You have a fresh, quick arrangement, and I'm just keeping it simple tonight. I know that I wanna keep it easy, I want cleanup easy. It's a Tuesday night here in our house, and like I mentioned, I'm single parenting, so everything needed to be easy and simple. And because the girls were like, what can we bring? I think it's okay to let people bring things. So if somebody asks, feel free to allow them to bring something. I think as a guest, I personally enjoy being able to contribute, and it makes them feel happy to as well. Using just all my plain white basic china, I have these gray and white striped napkins from Hearth & Hand at Target on hand, just my regular silverware. Okay, so here's a hosting tip for you. I don't necessarily have 8 water goblets that I love. I usually have about 6 or so. So a little tip for you is buy a case of ball mason jars if you kind of want something that's a little more casual and fun. It's a little, I don't know, summery, simple. So I have, they come in 12. They're really inexpensive, and then you can utilize these for our dressings and leftovers or whatever, chia pudding. But I'm using these as the water glasses. So that's that. And then if you also are hosting, you don't have enough matching wine glasses. I know they break over the years. I know I've mentioned this before, but go to IKEA. You can buy a pack of 6 wine glasses for really inexpensive, like $6 or something. So I always have a ton of those on hand to just make it look a little bit more streamlined and easy. And then for the soup, I didn't have 8 or 7 little bowls that were like, you know, like a cup size. I didn't want to have a huge bowl. So I'm just using, I have these little cute blue bowls on hand, which are the perfect like side soup size. And then I also had 4 of these cute little white coffee mugs, but they're very similar in size. And while they don't go perfectly together, they complement each other. It's kind of cute and fun. So don't stress or worry if you don't have all the exact same matching things. And again, if you want to use paper, go for it. Hope these continue to inspire you and encourage you to just open your doors, invite others in, and just love on people. And one last note, I just want to make everybody's time meaningful. So I'm coming up with some questions in advance, that some discussion questions like, what has been the biggest challenge for you since graduating? How does it feel right now that you're starting a new season, that you're not going back to school? What are the biggest takeaways? What's fun? What's exciting? What's hard? I'm thinking ahead about the people that will be around my table. I'm thinking about how to make it meaningful, encouraging, impactful, and just special. So I encourage you to always do the same, to just not let a moment go by wasted that doesn't give you the opportunity to just love others a little bit harder. So I hope you guys have a great day. I will be back soon. I am on a vlogging roll now. And in the meantime, if you haven't yet, I'd love for you to like and subscribe, and lots more Set the Table series to come. All right. Bye guys.